A very very good evening to all of you, my dear students. I am Manisha Das on behalf of eTuition family. Welcome you all to today's class. Let me remind you that our eTuition family is providing quality education for your better tomorrow. So don't be forget to be a part of our family. So this is the part 4 of the lesson Fundamental Unit of Life. This is for class 9, chapter 5. So my dear students, let me remind you that what we have studied in our previous classes, okay? We have studied about, yes, endoplasmic reticulum. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Why they are named as rough endoplasmic reticulum? Because they are attached with ribosomes, yes? Okay, so today we'll be discussing about rest of the cell organelles. So are you ready? So let's start today's class. So see what we will learn today. We will learning about rest of the cell organelles. Yes, so first one will be the Golgi apparatus. Next one is lysosomes and mitochondria. Then plastids, then vacuole. Okay, so these are the cell organelles we will be learning today. Then after that we will be learning about the importance of components of cell. Why these components are important? Okay, then we'll be discussing about cell division. How the cell divide? Why it is important for the cell division? Okay, so let's start with the Golgi apparatus. So first cell organelle comes today is Golgi apparatus. Can you see where is the Golgi apparatus? It is attached with the endoplasmic reticulum. The green color thing is Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex. Okay, so see, it is described by Camillo Golgi in 1898. Okay, so Camillo Golgi is a scientist who described Golgi apparatus in 1898. It is a single membrane bound cell organelle made up of sac like structure called as cisterns. See, these are sac like structure. Okay, these are sac like structure in which enzymes are filled. Okay, in which enzymes are filled and they are having one membrane. Okay, it is also having a covering for its protection and it is single membrane. Now cisterna are filled with various enzymes. So they are filled with various enzymes, as I have told you, and they are connected with endoplasmic reticulum. We can see in the diagram also. Now it helps in, what does it do? It helps in packaging and dispatch of material synthesized in ER. It means endoplasmic reticulum. In the previous class we have studied that endoplasmic reticulum helps in the synthesis of protein and lipids. Yes, protein and fats. So these proteins are attached in the endoplasmic reticulum. So they will come out of the endoplasmic reticulum and they will be attached to the Golgi apparatus and it will be packaged and dispatched. So how it is done, let us see. So now we will be discussing about the structure of Golgi apparatus. Can you see, as I have told you, these are the sac-like structure. Okay, these are the sac-like structure in which enzymes are filled. Okay, it has two phase. One is cis phase, another one is trans phase. Can you see, in the cis phase it is called as the receiving phase. It means it receives the molecules, it will receive the protein molecules and it will develop them. It will develop them, modify them, and it will convert them into a developed molecule. And it will be dispatched from which phase? Trans phase. Clear? Yes. Now see, it has two phases. One is cis phase, which is called as the receiving phase. It will accept the molecules. And next one is the trans phase, that is the supplying phase. Means after modifying the molecule, it will be supplied to the outer environment through the trans phase. Clear? Yes. Now the next one comes, function of Golgi apparatus. What is the function? See, it helps in storage. It helps in storage, modification, as I have told you, packaging. It will pack them in small units and it transport of molecules. It will transfer them to the outside environment. Clear? Yes. Now it helps in the synthesis of complex sugars from simple sugar. See, after digestion, the food molecules are converted into simple sugars. Now they are again converted into complex sugars, which will be taken in our body, which will be taken by our body. So the Golgi apparatus help in the synthesis of complex sugars from simple sugars. Clear? Next is synthesis of lysosome. Lysosome is a cell organelle which is synthesized by our Golgi apparatus. Okay. Now see, what are lysosomes? Can you see in the picture? Yes. They are filled with certain enzymes which are hydrolytic in nature. okay. So have you seen crackers, bombs? Okay, so they are like bombs. So they will burst whenever whenever except water molecules, okay, other bodies get attached to the lysosome, come in contact with the lysosome, it will burst and it will destroy them. See, a single membrane bound cell organelle that contains digestive enzyme, it is having one membrane, okay, single membrane, and it is containing digestive enzyme which are hydrolytic in nature. Now see, these enzymes are made by RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum make this enzyme, and it is also known as suicidal bag or waste disposal system of a cell. Before that, let me clear you that our animal cell or our human cell, we have certain waste products, okay, these are need to be removed from our body. But in case of plants, some plants store their waste products in the form of gum and latex, okay. But in animal cell, it is really needed, it is very important to remove these waste products from our body. So that's why which organelle help? Lysosome help in the disposal of this waste system. So that's why they are called as waste disposal system. And why they are called as suicidal bag? As I told you that they will burst if any foreign particle, any other particle come in contact with that. So what happens whenever any of our cell is damaged, what they will do? They will move near the cell membrane. They will move near the cell membrane and it will burst, it will kill itself also and it will destroy the cell also. That's why it is called as the suicidal bags. Clear? Yes. Now see, they are present in all animals and few in plant cells. As I have told you, plants love to store their waste products in the form of cell, in the form of latex and gums, okay. But in animals, the waste products need to be removed, so there are a lot number of lysosomes. Clear? Okay. Now moving ahead, mitochondria. What are mitochondria? Can you see the beautiful picture? Yes, it is called as the powerhouse of the cell. What is the function of a powerhouse? It provides energy, and this is the powerhouse of the cell. It means it provides energy to the cell for making or for doing different of function. Okay. Now see, it releases energy in the form of ATP. As I have told you, it is the powerhouse of the cell. It means it will release energy. But it stores the energy in which form? ATP. What is the full form of ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. Clear? Clear? Okay. And again, it has a double layered membrane. So my dear children, you have to remember that the organelle which are having double membrane, they are very very important. They are VIP persons, okay. So as the nucleus is having double layer, mitochondria is also having double layer. Look at the diagram. See here, one inner layer is there, another outer layer is there. So it is having double layer, two layers, okay. So the inner membrane, it means the inner layer is deeply folded. Can you see in the picture? Can you see in the diagram? It is deeply folded. Why? To increase the surface area so that a lot of amount of energy can be generated. Okay. And the outer layer is, can you see the outer layer? Yes, the outer layer is having, it is porous. It means it is having small pores. A number of pores or a number of holes are present in the outer layer, which helps in the exchange of materials. Which helps in the exchange of materials. Clear? See, mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of the cell because it releases energy or it generates energy in the form of ATP. It is having double layer. The inner layer is deeply folded to increase the surface area, and the outer layer is porous. It is having tiny pores which helps in the exchange of materials. Clear? Yes. Moving ahead, within the inner membrane there is a jelly like substance called as matrix. Can you see the jelly like substance? That is called as the matrix. And the folds in the inner membrane are called as crista. Can you see the folds? It is called as the crista. Okay. Now it contains its own DNA and ribosome. The mitochondria have its own DNA and ribosome. It is independent. It doesn't need anybody. Okay, and they can auto duplicate and synthesize proteins. See, it is having its own DNA, it is having its own ribosome. So why does it need to be dependent on anybody? So it can auto-duplicate. It means it can regenerate its own replica, own copies. See, whenever I am doing a heavy exercise, okay, I need more energy, which is giving energy to my cell, mitochondria. So there is a need of lot of energy. So there is a need of a large number of mitochondria. So mitochondria will auto-duplicate. It will increase its number by its own because it has its own DNA, own ribosome, and it will help in the synthesis of proteins. Clear? Yes. Now moving to the next slide. See, plastids. What are plastids? Can you look at the beautiful diagram? Plastids are only present in the plants. See, plastids are specialized double membrane. As I have told you, they are very important person because they are having double layered. So these plastids are also having double membrane. So they are very much important. Can you name the three organelles we studied which are having double layer? First one is nucleus, next one is mitochondria, third one is plastids. Clear? So it is having double membrane and is found only in the plant cell. Yes. Now see, it has jelly-like structure inside called as stroma. Here it is also having a jelly-like structure which is called as stroma. Yes. Now it contains its own DNA and ribosome. So plastid is very important and it is also having own DNA and ribosome. So it doesn't depend on anybody. Now see, types of plastid. There are different types of plastid. Mainly they are of three types. Okay. What are they? There are three types. They are leucoplast, chromoplast and chloroplast. Okay. See, leucoplast are white or colorless. And chromoplasts are colored plastid. They may be blue, red, yellow, except green. Because green color plastids are called as chloroplast. Can you remember what are chloroplast? Yes, we have discussed, no? They help in the process of photosynthesis. They capture the sunlight. Yes, chloroplast help in the process of photosynthesis. Yes. Now see, functions of plastids. So what does plastids do? Okay. Now see, chloroplast. We know they help in photosynthesis. Can you remember that? What is the byproduct in the photosynthesis process? Yes, plants give out oxygen. So chloroplast help in the release of oxygen. Then chromoplast, because they gives bright colors to the flowers. So flowers attract insects, pollinators, which help in the pollination of the plant. Yes. Okay, now see, leucoplast, they are colorless because they store starch, amino acids and fats. So they are the storage site. They store many of the molecules like starch, amino acid and fats. Clear? Three types of plastid: chromoplast, chloroplast and leucoplast. Leucoplasts are colorless, chloroplast are green and chromoplast are different color. Chloroplast help in photosynthesis, chromoplast help in giving bright color to the flowers, and leucoplast helps in the storage of starch, amino acids and fats. Clear? Yes. Now moving ahead, vacuole. What are vacuole? They are balloon like structure. Can you see which is the vacuole? This is the vacuole. They are balloon like structure, bubble like structure. Okay, so what is its function? They are the storage sacs. It means they store many things. In animal cell, the size of vacuole is very small. In plant cell, the size of the vacuole is very big. So can you think which cell this is? Yes, this is plant cell. And because this is having a vacuole and the vacuole occupy 50 to 70% of the volume. You can see in the diagram also the vacuole is occupying a number of space. Okay, very large space. 50 to 70% of the volume. See, if water is mixed with the minerals, it is called as the sap. Okay, it is called as the sap. See, it stores, which vacuole stores the cell sap. Okay, vacuole stores the cell sap, which may be liquid. It may be liquid, it may be solid food, it may be toxic byproducts. See, as I have told you, see, amoeba is unicellular, okay? So it engulfs its food, it captures its food inside the vacuole. Yes, and in the vacuole, the food is digested and the toxic byproducts are released with the help of vacuole. Clear? Yes. Now it provides rigidity and turgidity to the plant cell. As the vacuole is occupying the space, if the sap is entering to the vacuole, what will happen? The vacuole will increase its size, so it will be swollen, and so it provides rigidity and turgidity to the plant cell. Yes. Now moving ahead, importance of components of cell. So why it is important to have different components of cell? Can you tell? Yes, the cell get its structure and ability to function because of the organization of its membrane and cell organelles in specific way. See, a cell is having certain organelles and membranes. Okay, if they will not be there, what will happen? If the cell membrane and cell wall will not be there, what will happen? The cell cannot maintain its structure. Yes. If the cell organelles will not do their function, what will happen? Nothing will happen inside the cell. The functions will not be completed. So, for the smooth functioning of the cell and for the maintenance of the structure, the cell needs all the components of the cell working together. Okay? Now, they help the cell to perform functions like respiration, obtaining nutrition, and clearing of waste materials or forming new proteins. As we know that the cell is having different components, okay, they help the cell to perform different tasks, and they are like respiration, obtaining nutrients, clearing of waste material, forming new proteins. So for the smooth functioning of the cell, what do we need? Components of cell, which include certain cell membranes and cell organelles. Clear? Yes. Now see, cell division. What is cell division, my dear children? The process by which new cells are made is called a cell division. Can you see in the diagram? Here in the starting, there is one cell. At the last, I am getting two cells. It means it is increasing in number. So, the process by which new cells are formed, it is called a cell division. Okay, it helps. How does it help? The cell organelles and the cell divides. So, the cell division helps to grow and to replace old, dead and injured cells. Have you seen if you have any injury? After some days, you can see that there is a dark colored layer, bark like dead cells. After removing them, and again after some days, new skin is formed. How? Because the cell is, the old cell are replaced with the new cell. Yes? Yes. So, they also help in the formation of gametes required for reproduction. There are two types. Cell division is of two types. One is meiosis and the one is mitosis. Meiosis means reductional division. Mitosis means equational division. I will be discussing about it in the next slide. See, meiosis and mitosis. What is meiosis? Can you look at the diagram? See, let me tell you that we human beings have 23 pairs of chromosomes. How many pairs? 23 pairs. It means 46 chromosomes. So, in meiosis, what happens? The chromosome number is reduced to half. Can you see? Here it is 46 and in the next it is reduced to 23. But in mitosis, there is no decrease in the chromosome number. Here it is 46, here it is 46. Clear? So, meiosis is reductional. It means there will be decrease, there will be decline of the chromosome number. That's why in meiosis, the chromosome number is becoming half. But mitosis is equational. It will not decrease the chromosome number. The same chromosome number will be maintained. Meiosis, the process by which a single cell divides to form two identical daughter, means similar. See, here it is one. Here it is dividing into two. Again, this one is giving rise to two. And this one is giving rise to two. So, this is called as meiosis. In which cell? In gametes, this type of division takes place. Okay. Now see, mitosis, the process by which most of the cell divide for growth. So mitosis helps in our growth. They rapidly divide, maintaining the same label, same ploidy label, same chromosome number. Yes, clear? Yes. So if you remember that meiosis is reductional, it will lower, it will half the chromosome number, but mitosis is equational, it will not do anything with the chromosome number. Clear? Yes. So, my dear children, see, the dream of every cell is to become two cells. Yes, now only you have studied. Every cell is becoming two cells. So, like that, you should dream to be productive. You should be dreaming of growing. Yes, as the cell dream of growing in number, like that in your life you should be dreaming of growing. Every time you should be prospering, you should be doing good. Yes, so with this we completed this lesson. In the next class we will be discussing about all the possible question answers and some extra points. Till then, stay safe and revise all the previous classes so that it will be easy for you to give the answers of the questions in your textbook. Okay, my dear students. Now see, again I have to recall you so that you will never miss a video from our eTuition family. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Okay, thank you my dear students. Stay safe and stay happy.